gentlemen, I'm told that it appears he has jammed his neck in some way and doesn't appear to be serious on the surface, but they're going to take him.
3 minutes to go for the piggy bank. Goes out for the TV belt, and both wrestlers counted out.
This is Fred Miller with Georgia Championship Wrestling. We're speaking from Crawford W. Long Memorial Hospital in Atlanta. We're now speaking with Ole Anderson. His brother Gene has been operated on here at Crawford W. Long. What's the story, Ole?
Well, I'll tell you right now, we're just hoping, because after the match that we had on October 30th in Greensboro Coliseum with Flair and Valentine, they did some things that were certainly uncalled for. Pile drive Gene, ran him into the post and so forth, and at the time we really didn't know how bad it was, and then later on complications developed. He became completely paralyzed in the upper right part of his body, his shoulder, arm, and neck, and everything else, and we took him down here to Crawford Long Hospital in Atlanta to get the best possible care. And he was operated on just the other day, and you might as well ask him, see how he feels.
Okay, Ole. Well, Gene, I'd hate to bother you at a time like this, but the big thing the fans would like to know, since we are here, how do you feel?
I feel better now that the operation is over. But the only thing I got in my mind is Flair and Valentine. I'll get them.
Well, thank you, Gene. Well, those were his words, and he hit
the
point.
I'll tell you, I think that's... he asked me to put pictures up. As you see on the wall, we've got pictures of Flair and Valentine sitting there. And at first I thought, well, what the heck, what do you want to put something like that up for? And he says, no, I just want to look. I want to look at him. I want to be reminded. And in a way, I'm glad then. I guess that's good, because if this is what it's going to take, if this is the strength that he's going to be able to get from these pictures or whatever, that's fine. Because, as I said to Eugene, there's going to be a time when that thing is going to be all right, I hope, okay? And when it is, then what you've expressed to me and everything else, we're going to go ahead and do. And that is to go after two guys that are sitting out there. I know you're not supposed to talk about revenge, and I know you're not supposed to say you're going to go out there and... you're not supposed to say kill, right? But I'll tell you what, in this particular situation, when they tried to paralyze Gene, cripple him, we're done. We're done wrestling. We're done playing all the games and everything else. All the marbles, you can take the belts or whatever you have to do. You're talking about a human life here. You're talking about my brother's life. Sometime, I don't know when it's going to be, a month from now, 2 months from now, three, whenever it is, Gene is not going to be laying down. He's going to be standing up, and he's going to be working out, and he's going to be working out harder than he ever did. And together, the two of us are going to do all in our power to get a match with you, Flair and Valentine. I don't care where you are in the country. I don't care if you're in Alaska. I don't care if you're... No matter where you go, we're going to make sure we get a chance to get you. And when we do, you can rest assured that we're not just going to go out and wrestle. We're going to try to do what you've done. Only we're going to do a better job of it. Remember, Rick, all those things that we taught you. Remember the things that we've done. You know, we're not strangers to hurting people. That's been our profession, too. But the difference is, when we put our minds to it, we can do a better job. And when we catch up with you, whenever it may be, you rest right now. But whenever it may be, Gene and I are going to come. And when we do, heaven help you. Because I guarantee you, it's the last thing you do. We're going to see you on your back